Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com with some more free agency news. According to CBS Sports, the Lakers are among the teams that will meet with free agent guard Kyrie Irving. Now, they're not the only team, of course, that will be meeting with him. The Dallas Mavericks, the incumbent team, will meet with Kyrie Irving. The Phoenix Suns, the Miami Heat, the Clippers, the Houston Rockets, all of these teams will meet with Kyrie Irving once free agency commences, with varying degrees of ability to actually sign Kyrie to a contract. So let's focus in on the Lakers, though. Sure, the Houston Rockets, in theory, can offer a lot more money depending on what they do with their cap space. They've got over $60 million in cap room. What could the Lakers actually do to get Kyrie? And this is what I want to stress. Even though the Lakers are meeting with Kyrie, it is very, very, very unlikely that the Lakers will actually sign Kyrie Irving. The Phoenix Suns, again, have even less ability to sign Kyrie Irving. They essentially have just veteran minimum contracts, and yet they are still getting a meeting with Kyrie. So I would not jump to conclusions that this puts the Lakers truly into the race to get Kyrie Irving. But nonetheless, there are some paths potentially to get there. So, for example, now that the Lakers have taken Mo Bamba and Malik Beasley's salaries off their books for next year, if the Lakers wanted your cap space route and decided that all they're going to do is get rid of all the players on their roster, gut the roster, get rid of all the cap holds. Rui Hachimura, goodbye. Goodbye to most of the rest of the team. Lonnie Walker, Dennis Schroeder, see you later, right? Maybe you could keep Austin Reeves' $2 million cap hold on the books, and you go sign Kyrie, and you can probably give him somewhere in the mid-$30 million range, maybe about $34 million or so, something like that. That's what the Lakers' best top dollar offer would be looking at, and that would still be asking Kyrie to take about a $10 million pay cut compared to his max. So factor that in. The very most, even gutting the roster, the most the Lakers can offer is asking Kyrie to take a $10 million pay cut off the max. Now, the other thing the Lakers can do, and we know this is what they did when they decided to jettison Mo Bamba and Malik Beasley, for now, both could potentially come back. But when they made that move, they opened up the mid-level exception. If Kyrie says, you know what, I'll play for less, I'll take the mid-level, all right, fine, then off you go. Hard to imagine, though, that Kyrie would be willing to play for $12.4 million, particularly when you have other teams like the Mavs, like the Rockets, that can offer a lot more money. Now, the Clippers, the Suns, they can't offer much. They can offer veteran minimums, and that's about it. The belief is that what Kyrie is really doing, this isn't about him really considering going somewhere else. This is mostly about convincing the Dallas Mavericks that there are other teams that Kyrie could go to, and using that leverage to get the kind of deal out of the Mavs that Kyrie wants. So that is most likely what's happening here. But if you're the Lakers and Kyrie wants to meet, why not meet? You're not going to be able to meet with him after he signs with the Mavs, if that's actually what happens. So why not meet? Build a relationship, get a little bit of intel. You never know. Maybe down the road, a year, 2 years from now, whatever, building that relationship up a little bit right now may come to fruition into something else. So even though it's extremely unlikely for the Lakers to actually sign Kyrie Irving, it still makes sense to go ahead and take the meeting, find out what you can, and then go from there. Of course, combining Kyrie with old friend LeBron James, who he's won an NBA championship with, that's got to hold some appeal. But in terms of a contract, the Lakers just can't get to where the Houston Rockets can get, or certainly the heavy favorite, the Dallas Mavericks, the incumbent team, can get with him. Everything we've heard about the Lakers and their plans in free agency is that they're going to keep the prior year's team, they're going to keep the young core, keep it together, and then move on from there and try to build on with that chemistry. So I would be very, very surprised if the Lakers scrapped their whole plan and shifted to pursue Kyrie Irving. But nonetheless, again, CBS reporting that the Lakers will indeed meet with Kyrie Irving. There's also a report floating around that the Lakers might meet with Dillon Brooks. Doesn't provide the kind of shooting that the Lakers need. And of course, had plenty of run-ins with the Lakers during the playoffs this last season. But the Lakers are looking for tough, defensive-minded players, and Dillon Brooks does kind of fit that bill. But again, this would be a shocking target with the mid-level exception if the Lakers really did go after Dillon Brooks. So a couple of interesting names out there that the Lakers look like they're going to be meeting with once free agency kicks off again. Free agency officially starts 3 o'clock Pacific time today. We will be live right here on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel, breaking everything down. We're going to go live at 2 o'clock Pacific time. Come join us for our NBA free agency show. It's going to be a lot of fun. Till then, everybody, see ya and stay safe.